An electrical signal travels through a communication channel or links at a certain area in space or in a defined frequency band or for a known segment of time. When these three elements, that is space, frequency and time, are all the same for two or more signals, interference or conflicts occur. Multiplexing is a technique for allowing more than one signal to coexist in the channel by developing a scheme to share the space, frequency and time all together. Multiplexing makes better use of the channel capacity. Multiplexing allows several different signals to be clustered into a single group so that they can be handled as a single entity. For example, suppose audio and video signal of TV broadcasting are multiplexed together and handled through the transmitter and receiver signal as a single quantity until they are split and separately demodulated after they are received. There are basically three different types of multiplexing. First of them is space division multiplexing. In space division multiplexing, multiple physical paths are established by adding new physical links alongside the existing ones. Suppose we have Ethernet connection, or in old time the landline telephone cables, they have multiple pairs of cables for end to end point. So if you are having three different signals to be sent at the same time, you need three different channels at the same time. So this is called space division multiplexing. Second one is frequency division multiplexing, also known as FDM. In FDM, each user signal modulates at different carrier frequencies, and these different carrier frequencies are clustered together at the same time. So if you have five different messages, so they are modulated at five different carrier signal frequencies. So they can be treated as five different signals, and they all have different carrier frequency. And at the same time, we can send all of them to a single channel. So the overall available bandwidth is divided between these five channels. So each user transmits with no limitation of time, and different users are in separate frequency domains. The last one is time division multiplexing, or also known as TDM. Here, each signal is assigned a time interval or time slot and gets in queue in the sequence at using the channel link and frequencies. Each user is allowed to transmit only within specific interval of time or slots, and different user transmits in different time slots. But in given time slot, the user can transmit throughout the bandwidth. Suppose you have 8 bit of data and each single bit takes 1 microsecond of time to be transmitted. So 8 bit data requires 8 microsecond times. And the sampling frequency or sampling time, suppose, is 100 microsecond. So after sending the 8 microsecond of data burst, you will have around 92 microsecond of time empty within this channel. So these 92 microseconds would be used for other users so that they can transmit their allotted time. Suppose each have 8 microseconds, so they can have their 8 microsecond of time slots to transmit data. After 100 microsecond is completed, then again the channel 1 or the user 1 will have 8 microsecond of time slot for data transmission. In this picture, you can see that there is small gaps between different signals in the time domain. These gaps are called guard time. They are used so as to avoid any overlapping between two successive signals. Between FDM and TDM, the frequency division is very simple. All transmitters sharing the medium have output power spectra in non-overlapping bands. Compared to FDM, TDM has different propagation delays for different channels, so it becomes complicated. But FDM is expensive and its bandpass filters are complicated. whereas the TDM has very basic logic formulas and functions. So primarily it is cheaper than the FDM system. Another disadvantage of FDM is that it requires a strict linearity of the medium, whereas in TDM there is no such requirement. Overall, none of the three types of multiplexing is inherently better than the other two. The best choice for an application depends on the available bandwidth, distance, number and type of signals, cost and complexity, and reliability.